Welcome to our lecture online. So now let's use what we've learned. We figured out on the previous video how to define an area element in spherical coordinates, and now let's use that to find the surface area of a sphere of radius r. Now what's interesting, and you might not have noticed that there's no dr right here. So we don't have to integrate over the distance r. That's because on a sphere, where the center is at the origin, the distance r to the surface of the sphere is a constant. It's always equal to r, so that means that the r squared can actually come outside the integral sign. So to find the area, it's the integral of dA. dA was defined as this, and so r can come outside the integral sign. So this becomes equal to r squared times the double integral of the sine of theta d phi d theta. All right, so now it becomes just integrating that. It's a double integral. And the limits of integration, it turns out that for the angle phi, we go all the way around the circle. So we go from 0 to 2 pi. And for the angle theta, we go anywhere from 0 all the way to 180. So we go from up all the way down. And then we go all the way around the circle to get the full surface of the sphere. So this looks as follows. This is equal to r squared times the integral of d theta, let's go d phi, let's make this d phi, times the integral of sine of theta d theta. Let's just do that. It doesn't matter what the order is that we do it in, we could do it in either order. So theta will go from 0 to pi, and phi will go from 0 to 2 pi. So let's do this one first. So this is equal to r squared times the integral from 0 to 2 pi of d phi times. Now the integral of the sine of theta is the negative cosine of theta, the negative cosine of theta evaluated from 0 to pi, which is equal to r squared times the integral of d phi from 0 to 2 pi, and then we multiply the times when we plug in the upper limit. Now the cosine of pi, well, let's see here, let's put a negative like this so we don't get confused with the sine, so I pulled out the negative. The cosine of pi is a negative 1, and we subtract from that the cosine of 0. Now the cosine of 0 is 1, but we're subtracting it, so we have negative 1 again. So we have a negative 1, negative 1, that's negative 2, times the negative is positive 2, so this becomes equal to 2r squared times the integral of d phi from 0 to 2 pi. So that, when we integrate that, we get 2r squared times the angle of phi from 0 to 2 pi. So when we plug in the lower limit, we get nothing. Plug in the upper limit, we get 2 pi. So this is 2r squared. That's a terrible looking r. Let me try that again. R squared times 2 pi. Multiply that times 2. So we get 4 pi times r squared. And that is indeed the surface area of a sphere. So that's how we apply the definition of the dA, a surface element on a sphere in spherical coordinates. Then we realize that dA is simply a double integral over theta and phi. R becomes constant, so it goes outside. And then the rest, you just follow the methodology. And that is how it's done.